recording live. give a warm welcome to our seniors, the class of 2021. Welcome to the 117th annual gym drill at the Bryn Mawr School. Just like everything else this year, things will be a little different, but no less celebratory. For this very special gym drill, a moment of actually gathering together that is no less than breathtaking, students and faculty have dug deep into the wells of creativity, innovation, and heart to produce what you are about to see. For health and safety, we remind all audience members and performers to keep their masks on, covering nose and mouth, sit at least 3 feet apart, and observe social distancing protocol. We begin with a land acknowledgement. I am speaking to you from the historic land of the Piscataqua, or Piscataway, which is known now as Baltimore, Maryland. I ask that you join me in acknowledging this community, their elders, both past and present, and future generations. And now, I want to warmly welcome some of our current faculty and staff who are alumni of Bryn Mawr. They march in honor of alumni far and wide who could not attend today. Music, begin. Alumni, mark time, march, and left. Forward, march. First, we welcome Kim Long Riley, class of 1979, Anne Eggleston Broaddus, class of 1988, Megan Walsh Nau, class of 1989, and Kathy Gubin Wax, class of 1990. Next, we have Georgia Summers, class of 2001. And I want to note that Georgia is celebrating her 20th reunion year. Marching with her are three graduates from the class of 2002, Julia Bielfeld, Emily Burks, and Emily Fetting. Please welcome Irina Spector Marks, class of 2004, and Deanna Boyd, class of 2005. And finally, we have Imani Coffin Robinson, class of 2012, and Malia Peacock, class of 2018. Thank you all so much, and we love the uniforms. Thank you. Gym drill by inviting our violin trio to play an arrangement of Joyous the Love. Welcome Michelle Fang, Carolyn Sue, and Cara Chow. Thank you. Thank you all. Absolutely stunning. Thank you. Special thanks to our strings teacher, Dan Levitov, who arranged and conducted this version of the school song. Joyous the Love uses a Welsh melody and was written by the Bryn Mawr class of 1935. At this time, I want to welcome our student speakers to come to the front. This year, student collaboration and participation has been integral to the fabric of Jim Drill. This year, student collaboration and participation has been integral to the fabric of Jim Drill. I would like to acknowledge our student choreographers, writers, artists, and guest voices, whose work you will see live today and in the opening dance film we released featuring grades 6 through 12. Thank you to our choreographers, Allie Gordy, Christina Susu, Ella Box, and Greta Ambrose. Our writers, Caroline Knight, Zoe Jackson, and Charlotte Wetlaufer. Our visual artists, Ayanna Richardson and Catherine Pear. And our guest voices, Sydney Booker, Kate Butler, Zoe Jackson, Caroline Knight, Anna Morrow, Callie Pakunis, Zawadi Sankofa, Cressy Mura Trainer, Olivia West, and Jing Jing Chu. Please note that Ayanna Richardson created the incredible cover art for the program this year. Thank you all from the bottom of my heart. And now, all students, please stand. Prepare for the opening exercises with your feet together and hands on your waist. Dancers are ready. Spread out. Thumbs up. Music begin. Thank you. Seniors, please prepare for the opening dance. Music, begin. Big, big, beautiful, complicated things happen. That's what today is about. We honor the pain and loss of this year, and we celebrate the ingenuity and community it takes to move through it. You may have noticed that we were not able to have all grades perform the opening dance live, but we invite you to watch the opening dance film, which speaks to a year jam-packed with challenges and the ways in which we fall and get back up again. Well, falling and flying is what we do best as dancers. Vulnerability is might, curiosity is currency, and with a strong back and a soft front, we model open-hearted ferocity. Here we go. Now, it is my honor to welcome Caroline Knight, Zawadi Stankova, Olivia West, Kate Butler, and Jingjing Chu, reading from text from our film, There Is No One Normal. Close, we open, we shut down. Narrow our senses, hibernating. We take hold on loose footing, face, feelings covered. I can't see you. Can you see me? We avoid, we consume, we don't. When was the last time that you exhaled? Did we give up giving?
Not if your smile has anything to do with it. Your resilience resounds, rippling, thundering in waves, fiery, fierce, following free. When trees are laid bare, roots busy themselves, humming, intent on afterlife, life after life after life after. Sprouts emerge, we trust, and spring takes hold of us. We see the signs, a collective sigh. Did we do it? Can you breathe? Are you seen? Didn't see you there.
Hi, this is me. I see. It's time and time again. We can't take hands, but eyes surprised. We practice. Okay? It's okay. Our hearts shake more than our hands. We open up this time. Are we there yet? Look, listen. We try again, lift up out of well-worn grooves, the void and the null. Old habits die hard in the nothing but We keep moving, broken and old. We come of age. We are in this. Are we? Do you see me?
Do I see you? It's raining and pouring and we are in it. We study history, our hands. We study where we came from and how. What is it? This is the unhinged. We're here with no door anymore. There is only out, up. We jump for joy. Who is we? Are you me?
I am not, but I am beside you. We walk together, writing out jitters.
Our bodies rage, our hands shake more than hearts now. We stop stopping.
Allow you, me, we breathe all the way out before in.
Come on, step to the edge. It's new. Are you with me? I'm with you.
Ms. Nichols, the director of equity and inclusion at my school, once said in her convocation speech, there is no one normal. And that in and of itself is powerful because we live in a society, a place of anxiety, where the only way to breathe is to hide authenticity. To formulate and orient yourself in a manner that submits to other people's standards, to manifest an illusion that instigates confusion of self-identity and inclusion. Community is beauty, stemming from a myriad of ethnicities, but abused by lumberjack axes like fight all the blacks, men are entitled to react, women can't bounce back, screw your panic attack, and stay in your place or know how to act. If I rearrange the phrase without turning it sideways, I can believe that there, no one is normal. But where is there? A place that doesn't debate whether it's okay to discriminate. A place that doesn't calculate body weight as a personality trait. A place where that skirt's so provocative isn't stuffed down my esophagus. A place where individuality does not equate to a crime of the first degree. When I spread my eyelids apart, I want to see colorful art constructed and empathized by the human heart. In reality, I see fake originality smiles appear, but I wonder, are they masks of fear? I don't want different to be ignorant. I want normal to be deplorable. Too many people suffer from shame of revealing themselves to the world. And when they've developed an immunity to disrespect, society interjects and suggests, I advise that you normalize. Normalize. And by normalize, do you mean normalize the lies that strengthen our society's divide? Or maybe you mean be kind, wide-eyed, and smile on the outside, but suppress all the aching and crying that is choking from the inside, not just your throat, but inside your mind? Well, I am my own, and I will let it show. I don't care if I get looks or condemned to the bone, because I'm not normal. I'm not normal. I don't act normal. I don't feel normal. Same as Norman, man. I adore him, but he's too formal. Too many yes ma'ams and not enough. I don't care, man. It's not his fault. He just doesn't understand that not everything is a command. And as a result, his vocabulary's bland, can't expand upon why he's afraid to take a stand and confess his love for a man, because I know he can. But he worries society will treat him like a madman. So he sits at home in his room without a phone and hopes to abide by society's role set in stone for him. If society didn't so willingly uphold the stigma, no one would have to tell him, you are not alone. Ms. Nichols, the director of equity and inclusion. there is no one normal. I'll respond by rephrasing it. There, no one has to be normal.
Bravo. Thank you all so much. Students, please prepare for your cultural dances. Sixth graders, please take your places out on the field. The sixth grade will be representing the islands of Samoa, demonstrating two traditional dance forms of this beautiful South Pacific country. The first combines different movements based on driving rhythms and complex hand-slapping patterns. And the second dance is the slow and fluid Siva, a graceful storytelling dance. Music begin. Region of West Africa. We were fortunate to have former Bryn Mawr dance teacher Maya Ajanku choreograph and teach us this piece. She based it on the Ngoran dance of the Sanofu people, which celebrates the strength and beauty of the tribe's young women. Ms. Ajanku says she felt inspired by the physical and mental strength she felt from our own Bryn Mawr students. Music begin.
Thank you.
Columbia called the San Pedro. We are very grateful to middle school world language teacher Ale Balcazar, who originally hails from Columbia, for helping to create this piece and for sharing the history and culture behind the dance form. The dance is traditionally performed with some dancers in bright, colorful, full-length circle skirts and others holding hats and scarves. The skirts, hats, and scarves are a big component of the choreography. Our eighth graders will be showing the movements as if they were wearing these traditional costumes. Music, begin. Inspired by Haitian dance, specifically Yan Valu. We are grateful to our amazing guest artist, Panielle Guerriere, a Haitian dance expert and an internationally recognized teacher, choreographer, and performer. Yan Valu is a ritual dance originating in Benin. It honors all of the spirits of the Rada Nation. Yan Valu initiates the undulations of the waves as they rise and fall, and also the movements of the serpent Dambala, a source of energy and life. In the dance, the knees are bent to embody a connection to the earth, and the torso is hinged in reverence and respect. Special thanks to Irina Spector Marx for her presentation and conversation on Haitian history and how it intersects with the arts. Music, begin. Thank you. Thank you so much, ninth graders. 10th grade, please take your places. The 10th graders will perform an Arabic folk dance called Dabka, a Levantine dance with roots in regions north of the Mediterranean coast and Tigris River. We are grateful to student choreographer Christina Susu for her work in bringing this dance and its history to life. This dance stems from many countries, including Palestine, Lebanon, Jordan, Syria, northern Saudi Arabia, and Iraq. There are many versions of Dabka. Each dance has its own set of songs, and often the theme is love. Dabka, performed at weddings and other joyful occasions, is characterized by dancing close together, stomps, and dynamic gestures. Legend says that people in the region used to make the roof of a house with branches and mud. When the mud cracked, community members would help patch it by forming a line, joining hands, and stopping mud into place. These stories of community, family, and tradition live on through the generations. Special thanks to Monia Sheikh for her knowledge and guidance during this process. Music, begin.
طولك يا عود الريحان يهون عيون الغستان دك لك الأسواق الأسواق
from 2006 graduate Stasia Batter. The Cook Islands is a nation located in the South Pacific with 15 islands scattered over a vast area. During an annual event, all of the islands unite in one huge celebration of self-governance and independence. During this week-long festival, locals exhibit their food, music, and dance. Cook Island dancing displays are renowned, and the gifts of song and dance play a large part of the culture. Each of the 15 islands that makes up the Cook Islands has a different technique, which make their performances unique. Today, the seniors are performing their dances, Ta Reo, followed by Rapa Nui. Music begin. Bollywood dance has a strong emphasis on energy and expression. Today, the junior class is presenting Mahi Vay and Pala Chasma. Mahi Vay means my sweetheart, and in the dance, Ali choreographed steps to point to traditional Indian accessories like anklets and bangles. Kalachasma means sunglasses, and you will see dancers hold sunglasses. Ali was inspired to choreograph these pieces because they were among of her first experiences with dance and choreography. She wants to thank the amazing junior class, and she says, class of 2022, you rock. Music, begin.
तेरे माथे झूमर धमके तेरे कान बाली चमके है रे तेरे हाथों कंगना ठनके तेरे पैरों पायल छनके है रे मैनो से बोले रब्बा रब्बा अन्ने डोले रब्बा रब्बा अमृत ढोले रब्बा रब्बा तू सोनी है
जिंद माही बे जिंद माही बे
सोनी
Dancers are ready. Music, begin.
Don't keep it.
Let me see, 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 let
juniors, seniors, and class captains, please take your places for the banner exchange. Once you get into your places, you can be seated. And now I would like to thank a few people who helped us plan for Gym Drill in a year when making plans was impossible. Our amazing school nurses, Barbara Scott and Amy Robinson, thank you for your tireless work in our community. Security, grounds, and operations, thank you for all that you do to keep our campus safe, beautiful, and up and running. Stacy Watson, we are thankful for all that you do. Greg Shirk, thank you for your outstanding work as sound engineer. Thank you to Chief Advisors Emily Fetting, Kristen Hall, Emily Leitris, Tilly Taborda-Almaguer, Anne O'Brien, Rebecca Wish, and Justine Kadori. Big thanks to the Physical Education and Athletic Departments, Michelle Sapp, Tilly Taborda-Almaguer, Brooke Matthews, Tina Veprick, and Maggie Soros. Thank you to Ann Broaddus for your help with the banner exchange. And thank you to the Bryn Mawr Little Schoolers for being a lively audience from their playground during our rehearsals. And we absolutely need to thank Terry DeTore and Jeanette Budzik. Thank you for all that you do. At this time, awards will be given to seniors by our head of school, Sue Sadler, dance teacher, Emily Tankersley, and our all-school captain, Serena Cooper. This year, seniors are receiving a pin with the school insignia on it. As I call names, seniors, please come forward. Aliyah Adibenro, Marin Alessandro, Grace Anderson, Anna Andrews, Lila Anson, Anna Bakana, Lucy Barger, Anna Bezanishvili, Jillian Blum, Tanaya Bogier, Lucy Boucher, Julia Brinker, Jessica Ryan, Callie Chambers, Serena Cooper, Bryn Cross, Celeste Colors, Jessica Deck, Isabel Easter, Adore Ananuga, Mia Eventoff, Zoe Ferroni, Eva Feroja, Michelle Fang, Vivian Forthman, Naomi Fotinos, Elizabeth Georges, Cassie Gong, Sabira Hans, Caroline Hervey, Anna Hobelman, Jules Humbert, Nafia Hunter, Carrie Jang, Tara Kanuja, Ria Kosla, Sophia Kunisaki, Jesse Kwan, Mika Lee, Sophie Lahaney, Emery Lewis, Sydney Leba, Laura Loveland, Lauren McDonald, Ava Mammon, Adair Martin, Alexandra Max, Claire McIntyre, Marina Miller, Madison Miro, Connie O, Anastasia Paraskevopoulos, Elizabeth Polydefkis, Emma Rafat, Emma Rubin, Elizabeth Sarver, Gabby Sequera, Caroline Severe, Lillian Shattuck, Charlotte Smith, Cynthia Summers, Mariana Suarez Gaviria, Cami Sumpa, Cece Tironi, Rita Sapatsis, Cameron Turner Marks, Ruby Tyson, Favor Uday, Joy Uday, Kavya Upalapati, Isabel Verhayan, Paige Warren, Isabel Watrous, Grace Williams, Riley Woods, Sabrina Shu, Iris Zhang, Kiki Zhang. Congratulations, seniors. And now we have one more person to thank for her unwavering support and dedication to the Bryn Mawr community and for never-ending support of Gym Drill. We cannot let this day come to a close without thanking the one and only Terry DeTore.
Terry, please come down and accept your honorary Jim Drill sash. Mark time, mark.
Terry, we the dance teachers are eternally grateful for all that you do for us and in support of this event, and you will be missed not only for your assistance, but for your kindness, generosity, and sense of humor that has carried us through this year of uncertainty. We will miss you more than words can say, but are so happy for you as you officially retire from your years of service to Bryn Mawr. Thank you. Fits perfectly. At this time, I'd like to ask our all-school captain, Serena Cooper, to come to the podium. And she will deliver her speech.
Open, scissor, scissor, turn, in, out, click, together. These words have saved my tail the past 4 years. And if you have been a part of at least one gym drill, I know they have saved yours too. Whispering these words during the first set of open exercises is a common experience of gym drill. An unpopular opinion, I actually enjoy opening exercises. If there's one thing opening exercises will do, besides get your heart racing, it is humble you. You can be top of your class, leader of a million clubs, have the hottest significant other, but if you can't do those opening exercises, that's it, you're done. That's what I love about gym drill though. None of those things that refer to status or reputation matter when we are all out there on the field. It's just us in our pleated skirts and sashes moving in unison. For those unfamiliar with gym drill, the sight of this may be a little daunting or uncomfortable, but being right in the heart of it, I find comfort and a sense of belonging on this spring day. In a community where I'm very visibly the minority, I am constantly reminded of how different I am. Whereas part of me jokingly says, well, why would you want to be like everyone else? The emotional burden of these differences makes me want to just be like everyone else. Though, with these tough emotions, I have found support in various adults and affinity spaces on campus, such as the Black Student Union, and even spaces like gym drill. Because that is the magic of gym drill. The hierarchy that we may see and feel every day as a Bryn Mawr student disappears with a swell of school spirit. This year has been more challenging than most, and we all know that. Through all of it, gym drill remains my day of relief, a day to just be a Martian. And for me, just to be a member of the class of 2021. You all have supported me and been my biggest cheerleaders. Thank you for allowing me to be myself loudly and proudly. You all are the most hardworking, driven, interesting group of people I've ever met. Though we didn't have the chance to experience the lobby, gym lobby, or our own senior room, we have remained solid and I think have grown closer as a class. I cannot believe we are graduating soon and going our separate ways, but I am extremely excited for everyone to embark on their own journey. At Bryn Mawr, there is no one specific experience, but many personalized experiences. We may face different challenges on a daily basis and come from different walks of life, but at the end of the day, we are all saying the same thing to get us through those opening exercises. Open, scissor, scissor, turn, in, out, kick, together. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Serena, for your marvelous and very moving speech. At this time, I want to take a moment to recognize the creative engines who make all of this possible. I may be on the mic, but this is a three-woman team of dance educators. Emily Tankersley and Anne O'Brien, you make everything happen and there are no words. Your scope of vision, level of research, and movement expertise are unmatched. Thank you for your steadfast commitment to our students as they grow through our program. Thank you. Students, we are proud of your work, dedication, and ability to tell your right from your left in Zoom dance classes. We see you, and together we move forward. Juniors, seniors, and class captains, please rise for the banner exchange. This year, each grade participated in the important ritual of voting for their class captain. This honorable Bryn Mawr rite of passage is special because the class captains are chosen to carry the banner by their peers. We're waiting for the 12th grade banner. Please hold. Like I said, as dance teachers, we model falling and getting back up again and making mistakes like I do all day long. Terry DeTour, you are not retired yet. Thank you. We can do this. Woo! All right, seniors, juniors, and class captains, prepare for the banner exchange. Music, begin. Class captains, mark time, march, and left. Accepting the sixth grade banner for the fifth grade is Farrah Macon. Accepting the seventh grade banner for the sixth grade is class captain Gail Lancaster. Accepting the eighth grade banner for the seventh grade is class captain Abigail Trinette. Accepting the ninth grade banner for the eighth grade is class captain Layla Geis. Accepting the 10th grade banner for the ninth grade is class captain Cara Chow. Accepting the 11th grade banner for the 10th grade class is class captain Meriwether King. Accepting the 12th grade banner for the 11th